This is ME242, solid mechanics. Okay, so this is going to be an introductory level class in the sense that we will go up to the linear theory of plasticity. Okay, we will not go into so much into the nonlinear aspects of elasticity, but this will be, the treatment will be very different from what you have learned, let's say in strength of materials. Okay, so basically in this course we will try to formulate partial differential equations which govern the fields, various fields like the displacement field, stress field and so on, and then we will look at particular solutions to those partial differential equations. So, if you recall, in our strength of materials, we don't introduce this partial differential equation so much. So, it is mostly just algebra, you know. So, we try to make approximations and then mostly it is algebra based, but here it will be more partial differential equation based. So, in that sense, this treatment is going to be very different than your strength of materials treatment. Okay, so that is the point to note here. Another thing is that some of you may have confusion about whether to credit this class or not. So that day, Professor Anand Suresh gave you some indication about this. So let me just mention one thing here, that suppose if you are interested in taking finite element method in the next semester, okay, so you want your project to be in solid mechanics and you want your project to be in finite elements, then in that particular case, I think it is better to credit this course. Okay, but suppose if you are interested in fluids or thermal area, and then suppose if you want to take CFD or something, then it is not required that you should take this course. Okay, you can still take this course out of interest, but this course will not be required, I'm saying, for CFD or something like that. Okay, but for finite element method, if you want to do the finite element method in the next semester, then I think this course is required. Okay, so I hope this makes the situation very clear about whether, so suppose some of you are still trying to decide whether to take this course or not, this will act like a guideline for you whether to take this. So, okay, so we will start with this. So as I said, that this material on initial notation is going to be new for most of you. So we'll go through that. Okay, so let us take, so we will assume that the space is three dimensional. Okay, so we will assume 3D space.
They are asking to write slightly bigger.
That's a good one. Okay. That's correct actually. Yes. So 3D space means that the vectors, suppose if I take a vector, right, then it will have three components. So if it's an n-dimensional space, then it will have n components, right? Or if it's a two-dimensional space, then it will have two components. So here, we'll typically assume 3D space, that means the any vector, we'll assume that it has three components. Okay, so in that sense. So now, suppose if I now talk about the dot product. Okay, so if I take the dot product of two vectors, so suppose A, I write as A1, A2, A3, and B as equal to B1, B2, B3. Okay, so these are two vectors, let us say. And if I talk about the dot product of these two vectors, then I will get A dot B. So that is equal to A1 B1 plus A2 B2 plus A3 B3. Okay. So this I can write now as summation I equal to 1 to 3 of AI BI. Okay. So I can write it in a summation form in this particular way. So now in this Einstein summation convention, what we typically do is that we will suppress this summation sign. Okay. So this summation sign we will remove. So here I will write this. So suppose this A dot B, now I will write as AI BI. Okay. And this I is what is known as a dummy index. Okay. So this I is a dummy index. Dummy index because I can use any letter. Okay, so whenever there is a repeated index,
That means there is a summation in Y. Okay, so but we will not write the summation, but it is assumed that there is a summation over the repeated index. And this repeated index is what is a dummy index. That is because I can use any letter, because it doesn't matter, right? So I can use, so this I can also write as equal to AJ BJ. So it doesn't matter what index I use. Basically this dummy index is something that is repeated twice. So the rule for this dummy index is that it should be repeated twice and not more than twice. Okay, so that is very, very important. So dummy index, so this is repeated twice and twice only. Okay, so it should not get repeated more than two times. Yes, so as I said that this the dummy index is repeated twice and twice only. So it should not be repeated more than twice. So for example, we cannot write something like this, okay? AI, BI, CI. Okay, so this is not allowed. So cross is not allowed. So something like that. So suppose if I want the summation over this, then I have to put a summation sign explicitly there. Okay? Suppose so there will be instances when I want it to be repeated over three indices. In that case, I will put a summation sign explicitly. But if there is no summation sign explicitly, then we cannot use this kind of a thing. Okay? It should not get repeated more than three times. So I will come to examples of that. And this is actually a mistake that most of the students make. So as I said, that I will clarify that through examples. Okay, fine. So we'll move on to the next thing here. So here, suppose now I want to write something like this. Okay, so the convention that I will follow typically is that I will use Greek letters for scalars. I will use lowercase English letters for vectors, and I will use capital letters for second order tensors. Okay, so that means, so suppose Greek letters will be typically scalars, then lowercase letters will be vectors, and uppercase will be tensors. So for the moment you can think of tensors as matrices. Okay, so we will introduce a more rigorous definition of a tensor at a later stage. So right now you don't worry about it. But right now let us just talk, like, I mean, maybe at this stage you can just think about it as matrices. Okay. So typically Greek letters is like, suppose some V, alpha, beta, so those I will use for scalars. Then suppose for lowercase like vectors, I will indicate it as A, B, U, V. So those will be the vectors. And uppercase letters will be like T, S, or R. So uppercase letters I will use for this one. Okay, so this is the convention that I am going to follow. I will put a tilde below that. Okay, so the tilde below that will indicate that it is a second order tensor or a vector. Suppose if there is no tilde below that, then it's just a scalar. Okay, so whenever I write about components, for example, then the component is just a scalar, right? So below that I will not put a tilde. So for example, if I wanted to write Tij, okay, then the ijth component of T, then I will not put a tilde below that, because Tij is just a scalar, right? That is just one component of the full matrix. So in that case, I will not put a tilde. So whenever I am referring to the full matrix or the full vector, then I will put a tilde below that. Otherwise, I will not put a tilde. In the book, I don't need to put a tilde, because there I have just indicated vectors by boldface letters. Okay, in my book or in other books also, they follow the similar convention. So we'll stop this class here. So we'll meet on Wednesday at 10 o'clock. If anybody has any other questions regarding the book or you can tell. Harish Kumar, you can ask whatever question. So Supriya, tell me, whatever. Yeah, you can keep asking. Tell me, what is the question? Yeah.
Yeah, so
That will start from tomorrow at 10 o'clock. But what I'm saying is that suppose if you are a first year student, I would not recommend that you should take continuum mechanics. That's supposed to be an advanced elective. So all those who are entering in their first semester, please do not take continuum mechanics. I'm stating it very clearly. That's an advanced elective which you are supposed to take after you have taken this ME242. Okay. So this is for all PhD, research, MTech coursework. This is just a general guideline for everybody. Okay. So take it in your third semester. Yeah. Unless you have already done something like ME242 before, then you can take it. But otherwise, don't take it for credit. Okay. You will be wasting your time. Yeah. Is that clear?